ना बीवी ना बच्चा ना बाप बड़ा ना भैया, द होल पॉइंट इज दैट कि भैया सबसे बड़ा रुपया। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, माय नेम इज अंकुश चिरिमार एंड माय टॉपिक फॉर द प्रेजेंटेशन इज नेविगेटिंग द इंडियन फिनटेक टेरेन, बैलेंसिंग चैलेंजेस एंड एम्ब्रेसिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज। सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, tie your seat belts because we are going on a time travel to 7 years back when we went to a Kirana store with our mom. We were not interested in the products which our mom bought, but instead we wished for a situation where both our mom and the shopkeeper did not have a change. Chutta. Why? So that instead of a change, the shopkeeper will offer us a toffee. So while our mom used to decide the products which she wanted to buy, we decided the toffees. And the real challenge back then was when the shopkeeper had a change and we had to convince our mom, like, mummy, chillar se aapka bag bhaari ho jayega, isse achha toffee le lo na please. And fast forward to today, do you know those toffee companies have reported a sharp decline in their sales thanks to UPI? Want to pay 79 for the groceries? Just take out your superhero smartphone, enter the amount, and ta-da! The amount gets transferred from your bank account to another person's bank account. And the toffee? Oops, no change, so no toffee. This is just one little example of how fintech have revolutionized most of the business's work. Now, let's understand what is fintech. While you all know it is made up of two words, fin for financial and tech for technology, the new technology that seeks to improve and automate the delivery and use of financial services is fintech. It has probably four major segments. Number one, digital lending. Khade ho qatar mein bank tak jana hai, khade ho qatar mein bank tak jana hai, are kyun jhel rahe ho itne dard, ye to digital lending ka zamana hai. So want to check your last transaction or want a personal loan? Just take out your superhero smartphone, enter the details, and ta-da, your task is done. So this says include fintechs like lending card and Incred. Number two, insured tech. Policy bazaar pe aapko mil sakte hain dheer saro term life insurance, to kahin aur kyun jana? Heard it? Yes. This space includes fintech like policy bazaar. It is a combination of insurance and technology. Number three, wealth tech. Tell me one thing, as a CS student doing an articleship, what are our major sources of income? Let's talk about the active one. Number one, the biggest stipend, reimbursement income. I know most of our reimbursement incomes are more than our stipend. Well, there are many partners and managers sitting over here, so let's not talk about it. The second passive income, the stock market, right? And then further comes the problem of fund management, which is solved by this space, wealth tech, which combines wealth management and technology. And the fourth and the last, and the biggest fintech revolution in the world, the most important in terms of growth, funding, and technology, something which we use on a daily basis. Oh, sorry, not on a daily basis, on an hourly basis, and without which we cannot imagine our lives now. And that is UPI, Unified Payments Interface. From everything, from Paytm to GPay to PhonePay, it includes everything. And with a volume of 11.2 billion, it has crossed a mark of 17.4 trillion. You know how much that is? 17,40,000 crore in a single month of November 2023 as per RBI. Of technicals and statistics, I understand. So let me talk about some layman language. So while you will find me very boring or maybe something like that, but I see the growth of fintech in India is just like our C exams. How? So first of all, it is fast-paced. Our study leaves gets over in the blink of an eye. Second, challenging. I guess I don't have to describe this one, right? Third, unpredictable. Yes, I'm talking about our results. So by the way, our results are coming very soon, including mine. So let's not go there, guys. Let's stick to the topic. enough of one-way communications. Let me ask you a very simple question. Don't you think if in an industry there are 100 competitors and there are only 3 companies which account for 95% of the market share, this should be profitable, right? But sadly, this is not the case with UPI and on the similar lines to other fintech as well. Why? So broadly, I could find 3 challenges. Number one, regulatory obstacles. Regulatory bodies like RBI, SEBI, IRDA want fintech companies to comply with stringent compliance guidelines. Number two, information security. So while you all know, we have clone apps for WhatsApp, which can show you deleted messages as well. Don't be sad if you didn't know it already. I have seen many. But still, we don't install them because we care for our privacy and security over any other additional features. Right? And that's this, my dear ladies and gentlemen, is one of the biggest problems of fintech. To protect consumer financial data online as cyber attacks are increasing day by day. Number three, market competitiveness and a lack of differentiation. So you see, for example, Google Pay and Phone Pay and Paytm, all of these combine for 95% of the market share. Tell me one thing. Tell me a unique thing in any of 3 of them, and you won't find anything. Even if one competitor snooze, the other 2 competitors can take their market share easily. And this is the competition. With increasing customer acquisition cost, increasing cash burns, and very razor thin margins. No wonder in future, today the transactions which are free on UPI, you might find a 0.1% transaction charges, which may mean nothing to us because 10 rupees, so the transaction charges would be 0.1 paise, but for them, they would mean the world. Now, let me ask, how many of you would want to invest in a startup now, fintech startup? None of you? Chyun, dar gaye kya? Guys, just remember, where there are challenges, there are opportunities. And opportunities in the form of access, efficiency, and experience. Access. So basically, in 2022, India had a smartphone user base of 66 crore people. That's almost half of our population, from just 12.8% in 2013. And this, my dear ladies and gentlemen, is one of the biggest, fantastic opportunities for fintech to grow themselves. Number two, efficiency. Now, how many of you remember those EIS subject in our CA intermediate? That most dreadful, most difficult subject. And we always thought whether it's kept to just keep the passing percentages to the lower. But that's not the case, guys. The same concepts of blockchain, AI, and machine learning are used by fintech companies to provide customized financial services. Number three, experience. The philosophical me wants to say you something. People will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will not forget how you made them feel. Because words are forgotten, actions are forgotten, but the experience remains. And this is a space where fintech can differentiate themselves from their competitors. And the last, I would just conclude by saying, phone pay, paytm se, gpay se, phone pay, gpay se, ya paytm se, ya upstock zero dha se, desh badal raha hai mera, inko apnane se, inko apnane se, fintech a jaane se, sing along. Fintech ka jaane se, fintech ka jaane se. I'm not good at it, but yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, Ankush, for such an energetic performance.
Hamari soti hui audience ko jagane ke liye aapka bahut bahut dhanyawad.